Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Okay, so now what I want to show is that I've been having this issue where I have been entering my details, right? So if I log in and I go to the main page, watch what happens when I refresh. So we've got a session, right? Because without a session, we can't see the main page. Now watch this when I refresh. It shows the login page. That's a problem. We don't want the user to refresh and then they're back at the login page, right? And then, they get confused. We don't want that. So the way that we can fix this is that if we go into Inspect Element and we take a look at the application section of our tab, we can see we've got a session which is stored in here, right? So we can see any other sessions that are stored in local storage. So we've got the session storage and we've got the local storage, right? So the session storage and we've got the local storage. This is where we're going to be storing it. So actually, let me show you this example here. We've got the access token, right? We've got the token ID, which is the bearer token, which is we've got the user's ID, right? And that I'm authenticated and that I can see the main page, right? Because I'm logged in. But the problem is when I refresh, it shows me the login page, but that doesn't make sense. So, the way that we can actually fix this idea of it is okay, well, first let me clear my site data, right? So, if I refresh, I won't have any session. But what we can do is that if we come up here to the updated code, so I've updated a few things. I'm actually just going to comment this out. So we don't have to look at that. I'm going to push this down. So this is commented out. I've actually added new routes, but I'll remove that for now. Another thing that I've added is that if there's a problem with a route or if the route doesn't exist, such as like this, for example, if I do testing, right, or test, it will show path not found, right, which is good. So anyways, let's go back to login. And by the way, that route I've added was actually this code here, which is route path is equal to everything, and the element shows this. So it checks if there's everything, and it says if there's no path that exists, then show this message here, which is path not found, which is just a paragraph tag. But forgetting that, let's fix this issue with the login. So when we log in and we refresh, we get this error, this problem that we see here, which keeps sending us back to the login page. So the way that we fix this is that, so we can see here, const session, we're getting the session, we're setting it state. So when I mean by state, I mean by the exact time we get that information. So we ha holding that information, right, as a state. So that's the status of that. So we're holding that data, right? We're using Supabase auth.getSession method, which means the authentication method, meaning we are getting the current session. So get the session of the user, right? The data of that session and set it to that state. Now keep it, hold on to that, right? Hold on to that object, to that session. Now, this is all JSON, right? Because you saw earlier that the bearer token was in JSON. But now it's holding that. But when we refresh, it's we authenticated, we have the role, but it's not stored correctly, right? So the way that we can actually fix this issue is by going to obviously use state up here, which is supposed to be null, right? And that would still give us the same issue. But if we just go down here and do JSON.pass method, right? So what we're going to pass is the current session state, right? So we're going to be using local storage for this. So we're going to use local storage dot get item and the current session, just like this. And then we just say or null. So basically, okay, why is it? There we go. So we're passing that the current state of that session. So once we get that session, we pass that JSON data into local storage, meaning we pass it into here, this application, we pass it into storage, the browser storage, and we pass it in here, right? So we get the session, that we get from Superbase, right? But we're storing that in the browser as well. And if there's no session, like if like or if there's nothing, don't do anything. We are using a useEffect state, which is what I forgot to wrap it in last time, so that when the application refreshes or anything like that, there's no error when the state occurs, right? So what we can do here is use superbase.auth get session. So we're holding that data. We've got that data of the session, such as the email and password of the user. Now we've got set session, so we're setting the session. Now in here, when we hold the data, right? So we've got that state. Now we want to pass that, but there is a certain method we can use. There's a method that we can use to pass this as a string. But you see how we are JSON passing it, right? Local storage, we're getting that session. We want to set that session in this section here. So we're going to say local storage dot set item session JSON dot string fi session. This is how you'll do it. So you can do the same, you just copy this, right? And you'll do the same here. Local storage dot set item of the current session. So we want to stringify Stringify the session object so that it saves it, right? And now that is it. So it saves that. Now, if we go back, we wouldn't have this problem. See, now if we log in, click log in, here we go. It's passed it in. Now, if we close this and we refresh, we don't have that issue anymore. That issue's gone. Now we authenticated, and when we refresh, it doesn't redirect us. It doesn't take us back to the login page, which is good. That's what we want. So now I can route on these other pages here. But there's a problem that I'm facing currently, and it's that these routes aren't protected. So in the next video, I'll show how to protect these routes. Because I cannot even be logged in or authenticated. I don't even have to have an account, and I can go to profile, right? It says path not found because I removed that path. So if I add that path back, then it will show. But in the next video, I will show how to protect these routes. And yeah, so thank you guys for watching this video. We fixed this issue that we were having with authentication, that this page, every time we would refresh, it would lead us back to the login page. But now we've obtained that session, we are holding that session, and it is stored now. So we won't have this issue of going back to the login page. Thank you guys for watching this video. I'll see you in the next.